Hello children, welcome to the math class. Dear children, now we'll discuss about chapter 4, that is fraction. Children, already you know about this fraction in your previous classes. In this chapter, we'll discuss about types of fractions, reducing fraction to lowest terms, comparing fractions, addition and subtraction of fraction, multiplication of fraction, then division of fraction. So first of all, we discuss about types of fraction. Let's see. First one is like and unlike fraction. Children, you know like and unlike fraction. In like fractions, denominators are same. In unlike fraction, denominators are different. Here you see, all the denominators are same, and here all the denominators are different. Okay, you know, upper part is known as numerator and lower part is known as denominator. Then proper and improper fraction. In proper fraction, the numerator is smaller than the denominator, but in improper fraction, numerator is bigger than the denominator. Proper fraction, for example, 1 by 4. And children, you remember, it is the possible to take out the required number of parts from one whole cut into parts in proper fraction. But in improper fraction, you see, it is not possible to take out required parts from the whole number, because here numerator is bigger than the denominator. For example, 5 by 3. Then mixed numbers or mixed fractions. A mixed number is a whole number and a proper fraction combined together. For example, 4 whole 1 by 5. Here 4 is a whole number and 1 by 5 is a proper fraction. Okay. Then converting improper fraction into mixed numbers. How we convert? Here we take 5 by 2. Step by step we follow. Step 1. Divide the numerators by the denominators. Okay. First we divide 5. Divided 2, then we get 2 to the 4, 5 minus 4 is 1. Then second step, write the quotient as the whole number, part of a mixed number. So here this is the quotient and it is known as whole number. According to step 3, write the remainder as the numerator of the mixed number. Remainder is 1. So this is the mixed number. And, sorry, this is the numerator. Okay. And write the divisor as the denominator of the mixed number. Here, divisor part is where? Here. Okay. And this is known as denominator. So, required fraction is whole number, numerator by denominator. So 2 whole 1 by 2. Like this we convert. Clear? Then converting mixed numbers into the improper fraction. Here consider one improper fraction, that is 2 whole 2 by 3. Step 1, multiply the whole number, that is 2, and denominator, that is 3. Therefore we get 2 multiply 3 is 6. Add the numerator to the product obtained in step 1, that is 6 plus 2 is 8. So this product and you add numerator. Okay, so 6 plus 2 is 8. Numerator value obtained in step 2, that is 8. and denominator is given, that is 3. So 2 whole 2 by 3 equal to 8 by 3. Clear? Then equivalent fractions. Fractions that represent the same part of the whole are called equivalent fractions. Here children, you see these all parts are same, means 1 by 2 equal to 2 by 4 equal to 3 by 6. Here you see all parts are same. And these fractions are known as equivalent fractions. Finding equivalent fractions. How we get equivalent fractions? To find the equivalent fractions, we multiply both the numerator and denominator with the same non-zero number, or divide both the numerator and denominator by the same non-zero number. So we can get equivalent fraction by both multiplication and division. So first of all, we discuss about multiplication. Here we take one number, that is 4 by 7, one fraction we take. If we multiply same number, both numerator and denominator, we get 4 multiply 2 and 7 multiply 2, that is 8 by 14. 4 multiply 3 and 7 multiply 3, that is 12 by 21, and this one 28 by 49. So this 4 by 7, 8 by 14, 12 by 21, 28 by 49, all are equivalent fractions. Similarly, if we divide the same number with numerator and denominator, we get equivalent fractions. Then example 1, create 3 equivalent fractions. Here children, 5 by 7 is given. We have to create 3 equivalent fractions. Very easy. We just multiply same number with numerator and denominator. Then we get 3 equivalent fractions. Okay. Then example 2, find the equivalent fractions of 9 by 12 and 15 by 20. On dividing by a common factor of the numerator and denominator, okay, we get equivalent fractions. Means here common factor, means here what we do, we just divide. Okay, we get here 3 by 4, here also 3 by 4. So these fractions are same. So 3 by 4, 9 by 12 and 15 by 20 are equal. So these are equivalent fractions. Then checking for equivalent fraction. How we check? Okay. To check or verify whether two fractions are equivalent or not, we can use cross multiplication method. That is, multiply the numerator of one fraction with the denominator of another. If both the products are equal, then the two fractions are equivalent. For example, here you see 5 by 9, 15 by 27. Here we do cross multiplication. Then we get here 135, here also 135. Thus, 5 by 9 and 15 by 27 are equivalent fractions. But here you see children, 2 by 7 and 11 by 9. If here we do cross multiplication, here we get 18 and here we get 77, which are not equal. So these are not equivalent fractions. A fraction in its lowest terms. A fraction is said to be in its lowest term if both the numerator and denominator have only 1 as their common factor. Okay. To reduce a fraction to its lowest terms, there are two methods for reducing a fraction into lowest form. Method 1, to keep dividing and given fraction by a common factor till it cannot be further divided. Okay, we just divide. Then see the solution. Divide both the numerator and denominator by 6. Children, you remember same number only you divide. Okay, means here also you divide 6, numerator and denominator also you divided 6. So we get 6 by 9, which is not lowest form. Another we divide with 3. 3 2 is 6, 3 3 is 9. So we get 2 by 3, which is the lowest terms. Okay. Then example 2, reduce 18 by 20 to its lowest form. Here you divide by 2, then we get 9 by 10, which is the lowest term. Then method 2. Okay, divide the numerator and denominator of the fraction by their SCA. So here you do what? Find out the SCA. So you first find the SCA of numerator and denominator, that is 24. Okay, so here you divide 24 both in numerator and both in denominator. Then you get what? 3 by 4. Which is the lowest form of the fraction, that is 72 by 96. Example 2, 14 by 35. Here also you find out the SCF, which is 7. You divide 7 both numerator and denominator, then you get 2 by 5, that is the lowest form of the fraction. So like this, children, you first practice all the examples which are given in your book. Then comes to my practice time 1. Keep examples of like and unlike fractions. So many like and unlike fractions are there, you can write. Okay. Choose the proper, improper and mixed fractions from the following fractions. Children, you know which is improper, proper and mixed fraction. Just you find out and write. Express following mixed numbers as improper fraction. Improper fraction, just you follow the steps which are given in your book, then you do. Here 12 whole 2 by 3. 12 3 is how much? 36. 36 plus 2 is 38. So 38 by 3 is the answer. Like this you complete other bits. Express the following improper fractions as the mixed numbers. So 14 by 3, here what you do, just follow the steps in your book, which are given in your book. 14 by 3 means you divide and which is remainder, which is quotient and which is divisor, you write down, and like this you write 4 whole 2 by 3, which is the answer, and you complete rest bits. Then comes to 5 number, find 3 equivalent fractions of the following. Means same number you multiply both numerator and denominator, then you get your answer. 6 number, fill in the boxes. Here you see a bit 3 by 7. Here one blank is there, children, you mark 15 by 10. Here you first find out the relation between 3 and 15. 3 5 is 15, so 7 5 is 35 we write. Then here you see, here one blank is given. So here we find out 4, 7 and 42 relation. 7 6 is 42 and 3 6 is 18. Okay, like this you complete this bits. Then 7 number, children, you see, reduce the following fractions to the lowest term. 7 number, reduce the following fractions to the lowest terms. Here, children, you just divide, okay, then find out the lowest terms. So, children, my practice time 1 is your homework. You complete it at your home. Thank you.